Like, I don't like dating. I don't like saying shit. I like people that are bold, you know what I mean? Are you bold? I won't single you out anymore. I'll leave you alone. You think about Baudelaire in the poem Mambo Shah, page 10. Listen, like a woman who's bold, you know, her vagina looks like two saloon doors with a six gun for a clit. You know? Not someone, like, I picked up this girl, she was acting crazy at the bar, like, oh yeah, I like everything, I like rock and roll, I like opera, I could do anything. And then when we woke up the next day, she became like Sarah Palin. She had like a tailored jacket on. She's like, yeah, yeah, about last night, yeah, yeah. I said, no, I fucked the real you last night, but you have to go and take the vacuum cleaner for my last girlfriend, please, I can't look at that anymore. You ever fuck hard just to get Sarah Palin out of your mind? How do you get her out of your mind? Sarah Palin. No, she's on my mind. I don't want her on my mind. But it perplexes me how this woman rose out of shit. Like, it shows that housewives have dementia in certain parts of wherever she's from. And because they were like, did you like Sarah Palin? You didn't hear shit come out of her mouth, right? She handled herself very well. Did you hear any information? Do you feel like you know what's going on in the country? She was very graceful. She collects Santa Clauses, so do I. You know what I mean? Here's a woman who stands up and goes, I'm a hockey mom. I'm a hockey mom. My friend was a Navy SEAL, a Marine, but I'm a hockey mom. All that means is you drove your kid to hockey and drove him back again. You didn't do shit. Why don't you be proud of what you ought to be proud of, that your daughter fucks at 16 like a real American, a real citizen. We're not proud enough of sex, man. My daughter comes to me like, hi, father, I met this wonderful man. Nah, go out and blow somebody and then talk to me. Have the balls to get fisted. Is there a joke there yet? Like, a girl tells me, she goes, you seem uncomfortable on the date. I said, well, I don't date. She gave me that upscale, upwardly mobile support group, self-help journal writing, God never gives me more than I can handle, you know, nurturing tone of voice. Like, you don't date. Well, let's look at someone we think he's dating now. Run to the mirror, call yourself Mr. Date, or give yourself a hug and have a scone. And I was like, you think this is a date? No, this isn't a date. This is just you witnessing me, unable to stand in my aloneness, having a good time. And she goes, well, calm down. Just be vulnerable. Be vulnerable. Be who you are. I said, vulnerable? Vulnerable. I'm an impenetrable tank of narcissism with giant wheels of loneliness about to roll over and crush you. Now pay the check. I'll eat your food, borrow all your money, live with you rent-free, plow you against my shower ceiling, break every piece of furniture with your gorgeous goddamn asshole. Or I could sit down next to you, put on a pair of khakis, a performance fleece sweater, say things like, can't complain, things are good, can't complain. I'll have the I won't disturb anyone frappuccino, and I'll make everything right and won't make waves muffin. Did you know we can email each other from the same table? We can email each other from the same table. I have an LED light display so you can really see in the dark what we're doing. Where are you going? Don't you want to email each other? Where are you going? I'm a guitar hero where there's no guitar and the opposite of a hero. I have the personality of an iPod. Blackberry balls.